he didn't call me up or anything. So I ran downstairs. I was going ballistic. My poor dog, Tessa, was terrified. And my brother, Harry, who's pretty savvy with technology and stuff, was like, dude, they've probably been hacked, bro. Like, they would call you, right? They would let you know.
This, you laugh. This is actually quite traumatic for me because I created issues because of this. Oh. I would ruin takes. Chris would be like, cut, Emma, you're doing it again. You're mouthing dance lines.
Like 99% of the time when people come up to you and ask you for something on the street, they are really very nice. And then just occasionally, like, someone will come up and somebody said, can I get a picture with you? And I just saying words, not meaning anything by it. I just said, yeah, of course, if you want to. And she just went, well, I wouldn't have asked if I didn't want to. I was like, and of course I was like, oh, no, of course you wouldn't have. Silly of me. Come up here. And then...
Still to think, Vegeta, you are on the cusp of having your wish granted. How tragic, although it is much more tragic for me. As a matter of fact, in all my years, I've never been so angry as I am now. How incredibly irritating not to have seen the writing on the wall!
It's like school to me. It's really shaped me as a person. In school, you learn equations and you learn spelling and you learn maths, physics. But then when you leave school, you go out into the big wide world and you learn about yourself and you learn about people and you learn about how you connect and communicate.
And some cabbages. And those three bags of potatoes that we lifted last week. And then the mushrooms the week before.
Yes.
Anyway, you need people of intelligence on this sort of mission, quest, thing.
I do not want to lose for the third time. I hope you guys pull it together, or God help you all. God help you all. I watch Sandra eat the male model, not kiss, eat.
This is about getting that training in each day and forcing yourself to do it. You've finished a very long shift and you were there 2 hours early, or 2.5 hours early for your hair and your makeup. And then you have to go to the gym, yeah. And it's probably a busy gym. And so I was very lucky in Budapest to work at Flex Gym, and it's one of the best gyms I've been to, one of the best public gyms I've been to.
Hereditary was just about to come out, and just as it was about to come out, there were all these whispers about Midsommar that was gonna happen that summer, and my team were so excited by it and had read the script, and they were like, look, if you're gonna Skype anyone right now, we know you're busy, but if you're gonna Skype anyone, it's gonna be Ari. And I was like, okay, all right. So like read the script, amazing. And I came back from a night shoot at like 4 a.m. and we Skyped, and we were both so exhausted. Usually at these things, whenever you Skype a director, you never really finish the conversation. You go like, okay, well, we'll see what happens in the conversation with our agent.
Sharks have to continue to move forward, or they'll drown. You know, mummies have their brains pulled out through their nose. That's creepy on so many levels. Well, if such a creature did exist, I believe its habitat and safety would be all of our responsibility to look after and protect.
There are three things I refuse to tolerate: cowardice, bad haircuts, and military insurrection. And it is unfortunate that our friend Vegeta possesses all three of these.
It's impossible! It's impossible! How are you supposed to get the idiot bag around it and stay in the bin? Look, it's not possible.
And I mean, there was a period when I had my kid where I didn't leave my house for a while. And then I asked, like, a fellow musician, he sort of said, how are you feeling? You're not becoming a recluse, are you? And I was like, no, but maybe. And he's like, if you're going to become a recluse, you need a big enough house to be a recluse in. And that was when I was like, no way, I'm out.
Nah, Glenn doesn't deserve her. All he cares about are possessions. Fancy cars, CD players. Even women are possessions to him.
What
I told him that Disney were doing like an interview, you know, for Star Wars, and they wanted to ask him a bunch of questions in a location in South London. And he was just like, okay, cool, what types of questions? I was like, things like, and this is where I took the mic, right? I was like, things like, who's your favorite son in the world? You know, things like that. And I wrote all of that down, and then, you know, there was no interview. I kind of scrapped that and said, Dad, Mum, thank you for all you've done for me. I now have the ability to do this for you now, and here's your house, and there's a Jaguar parked outside for you, Dad, so yeah.
All you ever do is disappoint and betray me. Cheating, stealing, friend-making. It's not too late to repent. Kill your friend now and end this. Listen to your conscience. First blood. That was fast. Your team is dead. Go, Poopy Joe. Saw. Kill Vladimir Bananas. Failure.
Oh, no, I'm not brave enough for politics. I have to report to the council. Besides, someone needs to be the poster boy. Let us not forget, Anakin, that you rescued me from the buzz droids. And you killed Count Dooku, and you rescued the Chancellor, carrying me unconscious on your back. Hello there.
General Kenobi!